Hey everybody, from a beautiful day in Skyrim, I am back at the Sea Dragon. This is version 3 and it's a mod by Dovahkiina Thay. I visited it previously about 18 months ago and she has had another go at this and basically just tickled it up even more so that it's even more fancy than it used to be. I'll show you where we are on the map. I mean, it was awesome already, but you know. So there's the Cataria, there's the Sea Dragon, you can fast travel straight away. The ship is free. Look at it though. Can we just take a minute to appreciate those gorgeous red sails? Your surrounding area might not look like mine, by the way. I've got the Solitude Dock overhaul installed. And this just fits so perfectly in this little bay. It's amazing. Made for it. Look how gorgeous the ship is. And this on the front, I remember very well the first time I saw this with the dragons. That is so cool. It reminded me then and it reminds me now of Firefly, if you ever saw that series, with the Reavers and the, you know, icky, horrible stuff all attached to the front of the spaceships. Well, this kind of reminds me of that. It's very cool, really cool feature. And to get the key, by the way, you'll find it. You're looking for this little thing, a burial urn. And there it is, wow, in all its glory. So she's made various modifications, not just to the ship, but also to its destinations and the ability to hire crew, which is truly brilliant. And I just can't fathom why other mod authors haven't done this really, because I can't say that it's something that I'm aware of really hearing about before. Wow, Skyrim looks amazing today. That big structure over there, by the way, is a monolith. Oh, so beautiful. And there's a hawker. So the ship is awesome. It actually looks like a proper working ship, doesn't it? So there are three entrances, this door and the two hatches. Oh wow. And then, like I say, it's a proper working ship with new destinations. So just click on the ship's wheel. And you can go to Solitude, Windhelm, Dawnstar, Solstheim, or the Wilderness, which basically just takes you out here somewhere. Where are we? I think it was round about there-ish. Just right out in the middle of nowhere, so, you know. You fancy getting away from it all? So, yeah, that's the outside, and it's very fab and groovy. All right, it's on three levels, this place. And I've turned the music off inside only because I'm not sure if I'm going to get a copyright strike or not. As often happens, I video these places and then find I'm in trouble and have to go back and re-edit and all sorts. So, you know, some people have copyrighted their music and I can't show it in the video, basically. I can't let you hear it. But it's pretty fab and you know, lively sort of sea shanty type tune. I'll put something else over its place. So, this entrance hall, for want of a better word, lovely, isn't it? It's a really nice kind of formal greeting area. Some trophy bases, bags of bookcases, weapon plaques. All these display cases, I've tested, they work. Ignore that guy just for the moment. I'll explain more about him in a sec, but here's your office, and this is very nice. She has really, I remember this office quite well because I was enchanted with it, and this is actually even nicer. So look at these little fertile soils, oh my god. There's also a whole bunch of ingredients in that seed chest. Ring of Namira, potion racks, more soils, bunch of ingredients to take. Your alchemy lab, your enchanting. And as you can see, there's loads of cupboard space. There's also some name storage here and there. Oh, look at that. You can put your paragons up there. How nice. You've really got to keep your eyes open because I've noticed this is a bit of a trait with her that she mixes in things with the decoration that she adds. And that is so nice because it kind of gives you an element of control over the decoration. And I appreciate that so much. So, bookcases, nice desk, It really feels like a kind of captain-y type office. More soils. Another potion rack. A really nice workroom. Somewhere for your black books. Various busts. Claws. More busts. And books. So yeah, I like that a lot. It's nice and big and welcoming. You can imagine, you know, doing your interviews, keeping your people out here until you're ready to see them. And I say that because you can hire crew. You can have up to 12. So 12 friends or followers that you've made in game. You can have them here as your crew. And that guy that you saw just a second ago here, here he is sitting at the dining table. By the way, he and Inigo, who's in here, both of them, don't walk off when I'm speaking to you. Both of them are making full use of this place. So this dude, I picked him up at Windstat Mine and asked him if he wanted to be a crew member. And so, yep, he just turned up here. I mean, it's absolutely awesome, this. So I have various different options that I can speak to him about. I can tell him it's Christmas, but only because I've got Springwood Estate installed, and that's also by the same mod author. So, yeah, she knows I'm a fan. Okay, yes. Come back, Taurus. So I can ask him about my ship. Would he like to spend a few days at my ship? So one of the options is I can ask him to leave and he'll just go back to Windstat Mine where I found him. I can ask him for a room for my kids. Now, you can actually have two. I've already got one, so I'll show you that just for the purposes of showing you, really, because I don't adopt, but I know many of you do. So you can have two rooms for children, or you can ask for the kids' bedroom to be made back to guest room again, or you can tell him it's time to move. And I can ask him to take the ship somewhere. So, what? That is amazing. Let's go to... Oh, let's go Windhelm.
I'll see to it at once.
Thanks, dude. Oh, he's gone. Okay, so... That is amazing. I am stunned by that feature. And like I say, I honestly don't know why this isn't used more often. I think that's awesome. That's not just me, is it? That is so cool. Ever since I've, you know, downloaded this and checked it out, I've been like, wow, that is so clever. Okay, so this is what the guest rooms look like, and there are four of them, and they are very nice. There are bits and pieces all over the place that you can take, and there's also a nice amount of static decoration, so there's a good mix of both. Oh, hey, Inigo, what on earth? Okay, my bread and cheese is just... doing its thing. Hey man, what are you doing? Relaxing. His bath, look at this. All of the baths in this place, if you use the seat, it will auto strip you. Just a word of warning. But these screens though, they're my absolute favorite thing. They are beautiful. And I'm pretty sure that they weren't in this ship last time. I'm well impressed with those. They're beautiful. Very nice. So, what do you think of the guest rooms? Quite stunning, aren't they? And this whole floor, you can walk around. There are loads of these display cases and cupboards. Just a couple of mannequins. And then each side, that's your hatch to get back out onto the deck. And each side has chests, weapon plaques, and... racks, which you can, you know, get rid of all this stuff and put your own in. And it's the same over the other side. Very cool. More trophy bases, and then your bedroom, which, you know, I was impressed with the guest rooms, but this is very nice indeed. So you got some Empress clothing that you can wear. Wrong box. Bits and bobs in it. Bookcases. Gorgeous bed. Great big sea chest at the bottom of the bed. Nicely lit in here. It feels cozy. And then you've got your own bathroom. Really, this is plush, isn't it? Nice. I like it. With your own private bath. I was expecting this to be like a meditation area or something. I don't know. There's no activators though, so I'm not sure. Nice decoration. Feels really cozy. This whole ship feels really lovely. Him walking around with his Christmas hat on. So here's one of the guest rooms that I've turned into a kids' room just to show you. So there's room for three in here, and it's plenty spacious for them, isn't it? Bits of decoration. Ooh, I thought there might be more soils in there for a second. Getting carried away. I don't remember there being soils in this place previously, so I was really thrilled to find them. So yeah, it's a nice kids' room. So you could, you know, like I say, you could just change that and have two kids' rooms, i.e. six children. And then you've got the two big guest rooms and your bedroom. I awaken feeling rested. That's weird. Little message just flashed up on my screen. So what do you think? Very nice, aren't they? Loads of space for all sorts of things, as I said. And then you've got a sort of communal entertainment area here. Big dining room. Very lovely. Plenty of storage. I like these banners too, they're very handsome. Okay, and there is yet another floor. We'll nip down. By the way, just one word about these braziers. How cool is this? I love this little feature. That really struck me as being ever so clever and really nice. I like it a lot. All right, so if I remember rightly, the dining table used to be down here in the old version of this. And now look at this. This is very nice. Plenty of places for your crew to sit and hang out. Have something to eat. There's a bar area. Plus a kitchen. And there's no oven in here, just a cooking pot. Loads of ingredients. Oh, random money purse. Thank you very much. All right. And then here are the followers' beds, or your crew beds. They've all got their own individual chests. And wardrobes. And little rugs. I feel like they're well looked after, don't you? And it's exactly the same on the other side. And then as you get to the bottom, so there you can see the other side, you've got your smithing area. So anvil, workbench, grindstone and a tanning rack, plus somewhere to practice your skills. I love the whole idea of being on a ship though, I really do. When I was, you know, a kid, I think one of the things I really wanted out of life was to live on a houseboat. I don't know why. But, yeah. I'm feeling it. This is just lovely. And here you've got a jail cell, so there's the key. So, yeah. Just lock people up. Or torture them. Yeah. Oh, we got a leak. All right, well, I think that just about covers all of the main features of this mod. What do you think? I really like it. I think the upgrades and improvements that she's made are amazing. And like I say, what's amazed me more than anything is the ability to hire the crew and house them here. I mean, 12 followers is not to be sniffed at. That's pretty damn good, especially in a place like this where, you know, it's a really lovely place with everything you could possibly need. Oh, wow. Hey, we're at Windhelm. Oh, my God. I'd forgotten I'd asked him to bring us here. Oh, that's awesome. Oh, and look at that. It fits absolutely perfectly. That's amazing. Wow. Okay. Well, I will leave you with that beautiful picture of the red sails and call that the end of this video. Thank you so much, as always, for watching. I hope you've enjoyed it. Do let me know what you think about this home down in the comments, and I will see you soon for the next one. Take care and stay safe, everybody.